Okay, so in order to do the cockpit and the back fin, we first need to create a mirror of the current geometry. To do this, we need to first select half of the plane, so the one without the wing, obviously. And then we select mirror. Oh, if something like this happens, usually the case is that you still have some weird transformation settings. So we undo this, and then we go to modify and freeze transformations. So freeze transformations is going to change all of these values to the default values. So if I put freeze transformations, it's going to be everything to zero and scale factor is one. Now we can try to do the mirror again. And nothing happened. If this is the case, then we can check the direction. Are we mirroring in the correct direction? So we want to mirror on the x-axis, as you can see over here. And this is the plus side, so we want to mirror to the minus side. But we still don't see anything. Then what we can do is we can here move this a little bit. And move it back, and then sometimes it appears. Yeah, so here this is a minor bug in Maya. So if that happens, then well, you need to just fiddle around with it a little bit, and then you get your full model again. Okay, when you're done, you press Enter or Escape. No. Okay, then we just switch to object mode, and then we're done. At this point, it's also good to clean up the history. So we just go to modify, edit, delete by type history. Okay, so now let's take a look at the cockpit. Okay, so the cockpit has a slightly different shape than a square. So we have here something that's rounded, here it's straight, and then here it's rounded again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a multi-cut tool, and I'm just going to draw in some edges. Okay, so we would need here another edge. So let's undo that first and let's add an edge. So you can add an edge loop tool with the multi-cut tool by pressing the control key. So we need it roundabout here. And then I'm going to draw it in from here. Here. Yeah, so the image is not perfect, so we're just going to try to orientate ourselves to the preceding points. Okay, when you're done, you press Enter. Now for this point over here, I'm just going to add an edge loop over here. So here I'm pressing the Shift key, just that I can get the 50% mark perfectly. And the same thing then over here. Now we take these two vertex points and scale them a little out, a little up, and then we have like a better shape for this. Something similar we can do here for the front. Then we can select all of these faces. And then we can use the extrude tool, press on this modifier for world extrude, and just extrude it up. Then of course we switch again into a different view. Oh, I have a face too much selected, so let's undo that. Okay, let's extrude again. Yeah, so here we have a small straight extrude, and then it goes in a round shape. Now, instead of extruding this directly up, this partially up, so I could go like this and then scale it down a little bit, and then go up like this and then scale it down. I'm going to do something else. I'm going to extrude it up. I'm going to take this entire edge. And then I'm going to bevel it with a fraction of one, so for the entire thing. And I'm just going to add a couple of more segments. And this is how you can get a perfect rounded shape. And now, similarly to before, we now check in the front view how this matches up. In the side view, how this matches up, and then we adjust the vertices accordingly. So we're looking at a very precise shape. So what we may want to do is actually to avoid the specialist case down here and make this rounder again. In this case, again, we can use the V key to move it a little bit out, that we at least have it on the same level as the surrounding point. So maybe like this. And here we just can scale it a little bit more in. To give it a nicer, tighter, rounder shape. Or more aerodynamic shape, actually, in this case. So something like this. And then we have a cockpit. Okay, now for the back fin, I'm also going to add in a couple of edge loops for. Interesting. Okay, so I'm going to add in some edge loops. So here it added in now a few more edges unexpectedly, so I'm just going to select these edges over here and press Control Delete to delete the edge. And then I'm going to take these back faces and it even goes further up. So we need these two faces as well. And I selected too much again. So third time's a charm. So extrude these and then extrude upwards. And just as before, we just adjust the vertex positions. Let's scale this one down. This one somewhere over here. Scale this one down. Also, this move back a little bit, so this also has to move back a little bit. Yeah, so something like this. And now we just adjust our the origin where this is coming from. So to make it a little bit more slender. So something like this. So maybe this is still a little too thick. So we just scale it a little bit more. And just shaping the plane a little bit so that it looks more like the back fin. Okay, so there we have it. Now we have the cockpit and the back fin. In the next video, we're going to add in some more details.